Hi guys, welcome back to my channel for Final Fantasy Brave Exvius video. My name is David, I'm from Indonesia, and I want to share you how to finish this Clash of Wheels number 4, the Clash of Wheels season 2 part 1, the Tower of Unknown Origin. So this is on level 99 and I don't use any bonus score there, and the enemy is the Mordorim. The name is Mordorim, the skeleton castle. The weakness is fire, holy and dark. So the major weakness is dark, not fire and holy, because this boss has minus 20% of fire, minus 20% on holy, and minus 50% on darkness. And this enemy attack us with fire, earth and darkness, and also can be poison. And also don't forget this skeleton castle can inflict stop and zombie. On turn 2, this boss will inflict zombie to your provoker and change action after a limit burst being used. So this is my party here. Also, this is the equipment of the Esper Kokuryu on Sephiroth for Stone Killer. Another damage is from Madam Edel, and she has a terrible damage. And the other one is from Lara Croft. So this my party has a lot of limited time unit, just like Venera Venice and Lara Croft. So I'm apologize of that. This is my strategy to finish this. If you have the same unit, so you can copy paste my strategy to yours. So first, this is White Dragon Link, so you can get free White Dragon Link if you reach level 85. So you can pick a link, and there is now you can use the step up to get another fragment for in total I forgot. So this is my White Dragon Link. Normal form is not important, just to equip this Dragon's Brush and Call of the Wild, and also equip one of her STMR or TMR so we can unlock the triple cast this link without any vision card. So the most important thing on her Brave Shift form, because this link can fill our team LB using Dragon Dancer here, Passionate for Moments, and Celestial Dance here, and also can give our party 150% of AoE Reaper or Undead Killer. So that's all for Link. Next, for Sephiroth is my main DPS. Normal form is not too important. We need to equip this one, Rasasha Blade. I don't know this is tech or not. Has 10% of darkness amplification on the start of the battle. And this anti decay amulet. This has 100% of all stats reduction. So on the Brave Shift form, only 6k attack, because I don't have the vision card. I'm using a Link vision card here. So this is my Sephiroth setup with 100% evasion, and this is Magister Celestite Crown of Will. So this will give a 100% chain limit boost, and then so. Yep, I think that's all for my Sephiroth, not maxed out of the killer. So 400% true double hand attack, 125% of physical stone killer, and 275% of physical reaper killer with 300% LB damage boost. So for Venera Venice normal form and Brave Shift form, using the same equipment and abilities without any vision card, you can add more vision card for some of elemental resistance here. So I don't do that. So Fenella Fennes, on Brave She Form, she has 25% of AoE Darkness Amplification and 80% break, and also this one, not this, Umbral Dagger, 120% of Darkness Imperil. So on normal form, this Fenella Fennes has Marauder Blade, 90% of attack and defense break, and also the Umbral Dagger. Yep, I think that's all for Fenella Fennes. Next for Madame Edel, normal form, equipped with this Rage Speed Roar, because we need to remove the Imperil to Imperil on your Provoker. So my Provoker here is Fenella Fennes, so I must remove it and using her own Vision Card. Brave She Form, don't forget to equip the Darkness weapon, because when you use this Rage Speed Roar, so the AoE imbue will be removed. And yep, I think that's all for Madame Edel, since her damage is so awful. Yep, 300% LB damage boost, 275% of Reaper Killer, 225% of Physical Stone Killer with max out of through dual wield attack. So this is Aerith. I'm not using normal form. Brave She Form gear up like this, 100% evasion, Ibarra Vision Card, 350% of through double wave magic, and 75% of magical Reaper Killer, 100% evasion. So this is Lara Croft, normal form. As I mentioned, this is not, I don't know this is tech or not. So with equip sword, so this is my Lara Croft, Brave She Form with 100% evasion, with 350% of true double hand attack, 300% of physical stone killer, and 75% of Reaper Killer. So I think that's all for my team, and let's go to our fight. As usual for this class of villains battle on the Echelon 5, this enemy always do the preemptive attack. Oh, not for this one. Yep, not for this one. It should be increasing morale or something. So let's start with Fenella Fennes using triple assassin blade. This one, Shadow Serpent. This one, 25% of Darkness Amplification, and also evade 4 times is not important because our team is 100% evasion. And then Umbral Dagger here, 120% of Darkness Imperil, and the other is nothing. Oh, I need to break the enemy using this one, this Poison Sting, 80% break. I think is enough for the first threshold, because this boss has HP threshold on 50%. So White Dragon Link directly Brave She Form. Triple Dragon Dance, Medium Stance, Railing Dance, and Passion and Performance. So before we do that, let's start with Madame Edel. AoE Darkness Imbue, this one, Dark Enhancement Fighting Spirit, 15% Darkness Amplification and Darkness Imbue. Madame Encouragement to Sephiroth to fill LB to the max, and also this Rune Expedition Order, 100% of Stone Killer buff. This is AoE. So now Sephiroth Brave She Form, and Lara Croft Brave She Form. Let's do it. LB, and Aerith LB. So press Aerith and then White Dragon Link almost in the same time. Follow up with Sephiroth, and then wait for a second, and we until the chain comes and send Lara Croft. Radio 5%, Sephiroth 15%. We evade all the attack and the provoker is on Venera Venice. So Venera Venice will be inflicted by zombie. Let's see zombie status on her and lowers fires and darkness resistance to our team and this boss. Yes, and reduce accuracy. So let's start with Rage Beast Roar on Venera Venice. So the Imperil has been gone and now start with Venera Venice. I need to use this unstoppable protection because on the threshold attack this boss will inflict stop to our team. So White Dragon Link, triple Dragon Dance, Dragon Dancer, double passionate performance. This will fill all of our team LB. Repeat, doing the same, tap tap. Boom boom, yes. And we go to 50% threshold. And this enemy will heal himself for 5%. Now this is the most important thing for Venera Venice. Shift back to normal form and this enemy is reduce physical damage, absorb earth damage and counter, so we must remove it using this triple assassin blade, marauder's blade here. Remove same status. The this is the perfect dispel. Same status means the positive. Yes, the positive buff. And let's steal it, and then double umbral dagger. So now let's check the enemy here. Reduce accuracy, all breaks. This is 90% of spirit break. And then this lowers darkness resistance. So for White Dragon Link, let's fill our team LB, Dragon Dancer and Celestial Dance and anything here. Maybe you will use this Blight Step. So we will kill it in this turn 3. Let's repeat and Madam Edel shift to brave shift form. So this Madam Edel damage is awful, I don't know why. And let's try to finish this battle. So that's all we need to do repeat and repeat again to farm the echelon for the on echelon 5 because we need to farm the transition pearl in this boss. So let me check the damage breakdown here. For Madam Edel deal terrible damage that I already mentioned. So for Lara Croft and the Sephiroth damage for 3 times if I'm not mistaken. This is not the last round damage, this is in total, so we don't know the damage breakdown here. So the enemy HP is 1.1 billion damage or that's all 1.1. so in total we get 1.2. so I think that's all, and let's see if I can get the transition pearl. If I luck, my luck, it seems not all the blues. Yes, already all the NVX on 5 stars. So I think that's all for my today's video. Hope you can enjoy this video and guide you to finish this Morturim battle or the Clash of Wheels number 4, Clash of Wheels season 2 part 1. Hope you can enjoy this video and don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel to support me, and I'm David from FFBE Indonesia. Bye bye.